Hello, I'm Andrea, and I've got another video for you. I'm on Debian Bookworm with the Mate desktop. Well, I'll show you here, but I think you can see I'm running Debian Bookworm 12.5 with the Mate desktop. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can get to the Ubuntu theme Ambience, which is it was in Ubuntu Barnet Beaver on Debian. And well, I'm going to feature two themes, the current theme, which is the Yarrow theme, which is the current theme that's used in the Ubuntu LTS, which I think is 24, and also the previous theme, which was the Ambience theme. If you're running the latest version of Ubuntu and the latest version of Linux Mint, you already have this theme in the package manager, or it may already be pre-installed. I don't know because I'm using Debian. But in Debian, the Ambience theme, you have to install it manually, and I'll show you how to do it. First, you have to go to the Ubuntu packages website. I've got the link here, if I can find it. And search for the theme. This is the packages for Ubuntu 18.4 Bionic Beaver, and they even do the icons for Lubuntu LXDE if you want them, but that's not what I'm going to focus on today. And you need to download three files. Well, I've already done it. I'll show you. These are the three deb files you need: Light Themes, Humanity Icon Theme, and Ubuntu Mono. And you simp and to ins well, you can actually extract the files with Archive Manager or in Grampa, but the best way to install it is with the deb with the GDebi package installer, because then they go into the right folders, so the theme gets installed in the right way. The themes get installed in User share themes. You have to open as root to do this, and the icon themes, the icons get installed in user share icons, but this is the simple way to do it. Well, as I've already done it, I don't need to install it again. As you can see, it's already installed. And this package as well. So it's already installed, and I'll just close this so you can see better. Go into the control panel of the Mate desktop and go into Appearance, and here we can select the theme. And this is the Ambience theme. And you see it looks very much like Ubuntu now. And there are also other options as well that with this theme. If you want the traditional dark logo, you go into here, go into Customize, where it says Icons, scroll until you find. Humanity. And what I'm going to do is pause the video and log out, because I think I need to log out to show you the full theme. So I'm just going to do that now. So I'm back on the desktop, and this is the theme. And well, first of all, I'll show you how the folders look. See, this is how the theme looks on Ubuntu, and it's exactly the same here. And it does have these darker borders. And this is the mint menu, which is probably why it looks a bit different, because on the original Ubuntu, which used the classic start menu, the menu was dark. Well, I could show you the classic start menu. What I'm going to do is just remove the menu. And add the classic menu to the panel. I think this will display it better. Look. Then just move it over here. And lock it to the panel. There, you see, it has the dark start menu now, and this is how the theme looked in the older versions of Ubuntu. The menu was dark, and also the taskbar and start menu was at the top, but I like it at the bottom. I mean, I think it looks better, but this is the classic start menu with the original Ubuntu theme. And there are also ways you can customize this theme. For example, if we go back into appearance, there's also another lighter theme that it has, which is called Radiance, which is this, which gives you a lighter start menu and shell. And if you like the Ubuntu icon, you can also just make an adjustment here. Although you don't have to, it looks fine as it is. But so that's how the light theme looks. So abundance comes, abundance, abundance, or whatever, however they pronounce it, comes in both light and dark theme. This is the light theme now I'm showing you, and these how my folders look. And what we can also do is change the background to make it look like Ubuntu. So let's select a nice background. Let's have this one. There, now it does look like Ubuntu, doesn't it? And, what I'm going to do is put it back to the original dark theme, which is this ambience. That's the name of it, ambience. And the icons here. There. Now it does look very much like Ubuntu, and I think what we'll do is could make the panel dark in order to match the theme, which I think would probably be the sensible thing to do. That's better. Now it matches, doesn't it? I mean, that's how the original theme looked, because the taskbar was dark and the menu was dark, and these are the icons on the desktop. And you also have the option of making the background dark with dark theme, but I won't do that here. But so this is how it looks on Debian with a Mate desktop, the theme, and I think it looks very nice. With the wallpaper. Now I'm going to show you the Yarrow theme. which can be found here in Package Manager. I've already got it installed, but see, the older Ubuntu theme is not available in the Package Manager. You have to download it. The Yarrow theme, however, is, and it's already installed. Because I'm running the Mate desktop, I've installed the GTK theme, which is the theme, and the icon theme. You can also install the sound theme, but I copied that from my previous CD that had Linux Mint. And if you're running the GNOME desktop on Debian, you would install the GNOME shell, not the GTK. You'd install the GNOME shell and the Yarrow icon theme. They're both installed, so let's see how they look. Let's go here back to the control center and scroll down here. Now we had the Yarrow theme, but what I'm going to do is remove the menu. And what I'm going to do also is put the background back to the original. Yeah, I just paused the video and just adjusted the menu. It does look better with the Mint menu, and this is how the theme looks. You've got the icons from the Ubuntu Yarrow desktop. And this is how they look. And I think we'll change the wallpaper again because we'll change it to what it is in the current edition, well, which is this. There you are. And I downloaded these wallpapers also from the Ubuntu website. And the other one, there's another nice wallpaper that I've got, which is from the Ubuntu Cinnamon. I've also got other wallpapers. I'll show it to you. Look. This is from Ubuntu Cinnamon wallpaper, which is nice. It goes well with this theme because this is bright orange, and see the icons here. And you've also got different icons here with this theme. Because the current Ubuntu theme, the Yarrow theme, does come in quite a lot of with quite a lot of varieties. You've got Yarrow Red, which gives you the icons with a hint of red. Let's have a look. Yarrow Green. So all the icon themes are here. And it looks nice with both the original Ubuntu wallpaper and the Ubuntu Cinnamon wallpaper. If you like the So this is how it looks on Debian Mate, the Ubuntu theme, the two Ubuntu themes. And it also works on the GNOME desktop. This is Debian 12. I'm on my GNOME desktop now, and to activate the theme, you just go to Tweaks, which is this, and scroll down until you find Yarrow. And then where it says legacy applications, if it's here, Yarrow theme. And this is the default, so this is how it looks. On GNOME, and this is Nemo File Manager. And you can also change the shell theme to match. To do that, where it says shell, just select Yarrow, because now this is how it looks. We have all the icons here, and look, that's the package updater icon. It's even adopted the update icon for the software and updates. See, these are all the Ubuntu icons now. You see, if you want the default GNOME shell, this is just how it is. It's not transparent, but the Yarrow theme is transparent. And it's also got different shells, like Yarrow Red. See, the Ubuntu theme is transparent. And let's change the wallpaper to make it look more like Ubuntu. Well, actually, we can do that in settings. There. Now that looks exactly like Ubuntu, doesn't it? Look. And so do the icons. And this is the control center. Yeah. So this is the GNOME Control Center, how it looks. You can also change the wallpaper. Look. There. And also the ambience theme works on here. Go into GNOME Tweaks again. just search for it here. We want the humanity icons. And we'll set the shell back to the default now. So this is how it looks. So now we have the default icons from the earlier version of Ubuntu, which was Bionic Beaver. And there's also the other theme, which is Radiance. Here it is. Which is the lighter theme. And there's also the option of a dark theme if you want it, which really makes everything dark, but I tend to keep it on the lighter theme. Because the Radiance theme is supposed to make the windows lighter, but I believe it does. Yeah, makes the file manager windows lighter, and the Ambience theme, I think, is if you want the window borders to be darker. Although this theme was designed for, I think, GNOME Flashback, so it's obviously going to look slightly different in GNOME. Yeah, see, this is if you want the borders to be darker. This is the darker theme, and the Ambience is the darker theme, and the Radiance theme is the lighter theme. And let's see how GNOME Control Center looks in it. Yeah. And what we will do is change the wallpaper again to this, I think. Because this is the original wallpaper from Ubuntu 18.04, and this is how the theme would look if you were using GNOME Shell. So both the Ubuntu themes, the Ubuntu Yarrow and the older theme, the Ambience theme from Ubuntu Bionic Beaver, work on Debian 12, and they work on all desktop environments. I've shown you the GNOME desktop environment, which I'm running Debian 12 with the GNOME desktop environment. But yeah, so I've shown you the two desktop environments I'm running on Debian, well, separate computers. On the other computer is the Mate desktop, and on this computer is the GNOME desktop environment. But both Ubuntu themes work on all desktop environments. They also work on the KDE desktop environment, on the Plasma desktop environment, which I also have. So both themes, the Ubuntu Yarrow theme and the older Ubuntu theme, the Ubuntu Ambience theme, work on any desktop environment, including the KDE desktop environment, the same as the Linux Mint themes do. There, so it looks exactly like Ubuntu now, doesn't it? I mean, it's not, but it looks exactly like it. So that's it for now, and I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm Andrea, and I'll see you in the next video. Until next time, cheerio.